Welcome to VN Rock Channel, video channel specializing in classifying rocks, meteorites, and minerals. Please like and subscribe to support the channel's development. Non-magnetic meteorites. Meteorites with no or very weak magnetism are typically those containing little to no free metallic iron or strongly magnetic sulfides. Some groups of meteorites with little to no magnetism include 1.Ci chondrite, 2 cm chondrite, 3 enstatite, chondrites, 4 urolite meteorites, 5 aurite meteorites, 6 angrite meteorites, 7 lunar meteorites, 8 Martian meteorites. In general, non-magnetic meteorites are those rich in silicates without free iron, or with high oxidation levels but lacking sulfides and free metals. Magnetism of Ci chondrite meteorites. Ci chondrite meteorites generally exhibit very weak or nearly non-existent magnetism. Ci chondrites are rich in carbon and contain very little or no free metal, which is typically a significant contributor to strong magnetism in meteorites. Reasons for weak magnetism in Ci chondrites. Mineral composition. Ci chondrites primarily contain minerals such as clay, carbonates, and phyllosilicates, minerals formed through water interaction, which do not have strong magnetic properties. Lack of free metal. Ci chondrites have minimal amounts of free iron-nickel metal, which contributes to strong magnetism in many other types of meteorites. Iron in Ci chondrites mainly exists in the form of oxides or sulfides, like troilite, which do not produce significant magnetism. Magnetism of Cm chondrite meteorites. Cm chondrite meteorites have weak to moderate magnetism, depending on their free iron metal content and the iron-bearing minerals within. Cm chondrites are carbon-rich meteorites composed primarily of silicates, clay, carbonates, and small amounts of free metal and sulfides. Magnetic characteristics of Cm chondrites. Free metal and sulfides. Cm chondrites contain a small amount of free iron-nickel metal and sulfides, such as pyrrhotite and troilite. Although these free metals are much less abundant than in other chondrites, like H or L chondrites, they can still generate a slight degree of magnetism. Phyllosilicate minerals. Minerals like phyllosilicates and clay are formed through interaction with water. These minerals are not magnetic, but due to their iron oxide content, they can contribute to weak magnetism. Differentiating the magnetism of Cm chondrites. Compared to other types of chondrites, such as H chondrites, strong magnetism, or L chondrites, moderate magnetism, Cm chondrites have weaker magnetism, though it may still be detectable in basic magnetic tests. The weak magnetism of Cm chondrites is generally not strong enough to attract a magnet noticeably, but may show a slight magnetic response when placed near a strong magnet. Magnetism of enstatite. Chondrite meteorites. Enstatite. Chondrite meteorites typically exhibit weak to moderate magnetism, depending on the amount of free metal, primarily iron-nickel, present in the sample. Enstatite chondrites are a type of chondrite rich in the silicate enstatite, MnGsiO3, a non-magnetic mineral, but they also contain small amounts of free metal and sulfides, such as troilite and niningarite. Magnetic characteristics of enstatite chondrites. Free metal. Although the amount of free metal in enstatite chondrites is not as high as in other metal-rich chondrites, such as H chondrites, they do contain some iron-nickel, which produces a slight level of magnetism. Sulfur and sulfides. Enstatite chondrites contain sulfide compounds, such as troilite, which are non-magnetic but still influence the overall magnetic properties. Magnetism of enstatite. Chondrites, compared to other meteorites. Enstatite chondrites have weaker magnetism than H and L chondrites, but they may still show a magnetic response when placed near a strong magnet. The presence of even small amounts of free iron is enough to distinguish them from types of chondrites lacking metal, such as certain carbonaceous chondrites. Urolite meteorites have very weak or almost no magnetism, mainly due to their mineral composition. Lack of free metal. Urolite contain little to no free iron-nickel metal, Feini, compared to other types of chondrite meteorites, so their magnetism is generally very low. Primary composition, urelites primarily consist of minerals such as olivine and pyroxene, which are silicates and non-magnetic. Small inclusions of graphite and diamond are also present in urelites, but do not impact magnetism. Sulfur and sulfides. Although urelites contain small amounts of iron sulfides, the low total quantity does not contribute significant magnetism. Overall, urelites have very weak magnetism, which is barely noticeable compared to types of meteorites that contain substantial free iron or strongly magnetic sulfides. Magnetism of Chondrite meteorites. Chondrite meteorites have very weak or almost no magnetism. These are achondrite meteorites rich in enstatite, MgSiO3, with very little or no free metal content. Lack of free metal, Chondrites contain little to no free iron nickel, Feini, which is often a key contributor to magnetism in many other meteorite types. Primary composition. Chondrites primarily consist of the mineral enstatite and other silicate minerals, none of which are magnetic. Sulfides. Some Chondrite samples contain iron sulfides, but the amounts are very low, insufficient to create significant magnetism. In summary, the magnetism of Chondrite meteorites is very weak, nearly negligible, and difficult to detect with standard magnetism tests. Magnetism of Chondrite meteorites. Chondrite meteorites have very weak or almost no magnetism, primarily due to their mineral composition and very low free metal content. Lack of free metal, Chondrites contain very little or no free iron nickel, Feini, a common contributor to magnetism in other types of meteorites. Primary composition. Chondrites primarily consist of the minerals augite, a type of pyroxene, olivine, and anorthite, a type of plagioclase. These minerals are non-magnetic. Iron oxide content. Chondrites may contain small amounts of iron oxide, but not enough to produce significant magnetism. Overall, the magnetism of Chondrite meteorites is very weak and difficult to detect using standard magnetism tests. Magnetism of lunar meteorites. Lunar meteorites, moon meteorites, generally have very weak or almost no magnetism, mainly due to their low content of free metal. Very little free metal. Most lunar meteorites contain very little free iron nickel, Feini, so their magnetism is typically negligible. Primary composition. Lunar meteorites are primarily composed of plagioclase, pyroxene, and olivine, which are non-magnetic minerals. Some samples, however, contain small particles of ilmenite and magnetite, though these amounts are still insufficient to produce strong magnetism. Source of weak magnetism. If lunar meteorites exhibit weak magnetism, it may be due to historical processes on the Moon, such as exposure to the ancient lunar magnetic field or the presence of minor iron oxides. In summary, lunar meteorites have very weak magnetism and do not produce a strong response when placed near a magnet. Magnetism of Martian meteorites. Martian meteorites, also known as Chergotite, Nachschlite, Chasignite, or SNC meteorites, have weak to moderate magnetism, depending on their metal and mineral content. Free iron nickel content. Martian meteorites contain a small amount of free iron nickel metal, though not as much as in other chondrites, so their magnetism is generally weak to moderate. Primary mineral composition: Martian meteorites mainly consist of pyroxene, olivine, and feldspar, which are non-magnetic silicate minerals. However, some samples contain iron oxides such as magnetite and ilmenite, which contribute to slight magnetism. Source of weak magnetic field: some Martian meteorites may retain a weak magnetic field due to past exposure to Mars' magnetic field, though this is typically minor and insignificant. Overall, Martian meteorites have weak magnetism, less than meteorites with higher amounts of free iron.